Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with our Vue Carousel component. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how to add the Vue Carousel component to a Vue application and how to bind items to the component from a data source. Let me start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue CLI toolchain. Edit my code in Visual Studio Code, and finally, view the output on a supported browser. To install Vue CLI globally, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm install global Vue CLI. As I have done the installation already, I am skipping this step now. Then, I create a new project using the Vue create command and provide the app name, my Vue project. I navigate to the newly created Vue app. To use the Syncfusion Vue Carousel component, let me install the Syncfusion Vue Navigations package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-navigations --save. Once the installation is completed, my application is ready to use. The first thing I need to do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion components. So, I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To know how to generate this license key, refer to the link attached in the description below. Now, the application is configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. So, let me open the app.vue page and remove the default code on this page. Then, import the carousel component. Carousel item directive and carousel items directive from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Navigations package. And register them globally inside the component's property with all its child directives. Next, I add a HTML division element with the class control container to the template section. Within this division element, I add the carousel component by adding the EJS carousel tag. To add items to the component, I define the eCarouselItems tag. This tag will accept n number of carousel items in it. Now, I will add 5 items using the eCarouselItem tag. Inside each item tag, I add an image by adding the figure element using the template property. Within it, I add an image tag with the appropriate image location set to the source attribute. Then I add the alternative text to the image by adding the alt attribute. And set the height and width of the image using the style attribute. For better alignment of the image inside the component, I add the class ImageContainer to the carousel item. Similarly, I add images to other items as well. Inside the style tag, I define the classes ControlContainer and ImageContainer with styles like height, width, and margin. To apply styles to the carousel component, I import the material theme styles to the style section. To view the component in a browser, I run the application using the npm run serve command. Look here, the carousel component is rendered with images, arranged here as a typical slideshow. The images change automatically at regular intervals. Notice here, an indicator is shown to indicate the current page of the carousel. It also allows you to navigate to a specific page by clicking on it. You can also navigate to the next or previous image manually by clicking the navigator buttons. Now, to display a caption for these images, I add the fig caption tag with an appropriate value to it. I also add a class, ImageCaption, to it for alignment of the captions. Similarly, I add captions to the other items as well. Then, I define the ImageCaption class inside the style tag and add the required styles, color, font size, and position. See, the carousel component is rendered with image captions. Next, I will show you how to bind items to the carousel from a data source. To do that, I remove the carousel items already defined. I also remove the carousel items directive and carousel item directive from the component's property, as I am going to use template for adding data source items. Inside the script tag, I define a property called data, which returns an object named birdsList. To this birdsList array object, I add a list of items with ID, name, and image name. Then, I define a method getImage. This getImage method will return the image location. To bind these items to the carousel component, I use the datasource property and assign birdsList to it. To add images to the carousel, I define a template tag with the vslot directive and name it as itemTemplate. To access datasource fields inside the template section, I define a variable, data. Within it, I add a division element and add the image tag. To define the image location, I set the source property and assign the value returned from the getImage method. I add the alt attribute and assign the name to it using the data parameter. Then I set the height and width of the image. To add a title to the image, I use the heading tag and set an appropriate value using the data parameter. Finally, I bind this template to the component using that item template property. The carousel is now rendered with items retrieved from the data source. Next, I will show you how to add descriptions to these images. To do that, I modify the existing data source by adding one more field content with the appropriate description. To add this content to the image, I add a paragraph tag and assign the content using the data parameter. I have also customized the CSS styles like background color and margin for better alignment of the image description inside the component. You can see the images are rendered with the description. In this video, you have seen how to create a Vue app and add the Syncfusion carousel component to it. You have also seen how to add carousel items from a data source. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link given in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Vue products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.